Isle Royale is a secluded 893 square mile island in the middle of Lake Superior. This park is one of the least visited national parks in the United States, but the most revisited because of its beauty and seclusion. It has no human inhabitants, but is home to many moose and wolves who significantly affect their surroundings. Isle Royale is the site of the longest-lasting predator versus prey study in the world. As late as 2009, there were 25 wolves on the island, but after the spring 2017 count, just 2 wolves remain. Because the remote island is isolated, the only way for new wolves to get to the park is over an ice bridge that can form over Lake Superior during cold winters. Climate change is making those bridges rare, says John Vucetich, a professor at Michigan Technological University.
Our understanding of ice bridges starts with going back to the 1960s, ice bridges would have formed in about 8 out of every 10 years. More recently, they form in approximately 1 out of every 10 years. So from about an 80% chance of occurring in a year to about a 10% chance occurring in a year. Some projections would have the next ice bridge, whenever that occurs, could possibly be the last.
Because the wolf population is so low, moose numbers are increasing by about 22% each year. Vucetich studies predation ecology in Isle Royale. He is a leader in the Isle Royale Wolf Moose Project, which is in its 60th year.
That makes it the longest study of any predator-prey system in the world. And the centerpiece of that work has always been to count in the abundance of both wolves and moose. This winter, what we found out, basically two main features, that the population was still just 2 wolves. We also understand that it's the same 2 wolves that had been there as the previous year. Those 2 wolves happen to be both brother and sister and father and daughter. They do seem to still be quite capable of killing moose, which means they can feed themselves. The other thing we learned about the wolf moose population this past winter is how many moose there are. There are approximately 1,600 moose on the island right now.
When a predator population crashes, the ripple effects of that crash are known as a trophic cascade. In 1994, Isle Royale became the first known terrestrial trophic cascade.
And so at the top trophic level are wolves, and what sometimes happens is that wolves affect the next trophic level, which would be the moose, by reducing their abundance. In reducing the abundance of moose, it causes the next trophic level below that, which is the vegetation, to do much better.
Mark Romansky, the division chief of natural resources at Isle Royale, has worked on the island for almost 20 years.
So you can imagine, without any wolves, moose are essentially allowed to do whatever they want, and that could mean browsing to unprecedented levels. Some of the larger sort of forest system-wide impacts is, you know, with moose having impacts on browsing certain species, such as balsam fir. And some of the impacts include, like, changing the shape of these trees. Essentially, you know, you have 1 meter tall trees that are 30, 40, 50 years old because they've been chronically browsed. And so we're not getting regeneration of new, you know, of new balsam fir trees. And then that impacts also the type of forest community that you have over the long term.
The other really important creature that's affected would be beaver. Beavers will tend to be much more abundant when the wolves are not doing well, which is what's occurring right now. The beaver population is almost doubled in the last 4 or 5 years. And in doing so, they will make more beaver dams. And beavers in particular are what are sometimes referred to as architects of ecosystems. They really can change the overall structure of an ecosystem. They do this by making dams, and when they make a dam, they flood a river basin or a drainage, and then they start to cut the trees down that are in that area.
To bring back balance, the Park Service is looking at the reintroduction of wolves to the island. The possible reintroduction is leading to more questions about the National Park Service mission to protect the parks from human influence.
And if we're going to answer this question, whether we should bring wolves back to Isle Royale, we couldn't possibly answer it without first asking, what is the purpose of a protected area? What is the purpose of our national parks? And that's a pretty big and broad question, but in this particular case, what it hones in on is, what do we want to do with respect to climate change and our national parks? If climate change takes some things from national parks, are we okay with that? Will we just let climate change do that? Or if climate change takes things from our national parks and there's a chance to mitigate that or undo it, should we try to do that as well? That's a very big question. It's a question that goes much wider than just Isle Royale. And Isle Royale is going to be kind of an important, I guess for lack of a better word, test case for understanding whether we as an American people think it's good to try to mitigate some of these effects of climate change or not so much.
So the fate of the wolves of Isle Royale is in our hands. These are our national parks. This is Kim Leadholm signing off for the PBS NewsHour Student Reporting Labs from Isle Royale.